Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Honorable Premier,
Excellency Prime Minister of the Islamic Republic of Pakistan,
Pakistan, Mr. Imran Khan, Excellence Monsieur Sheikh Mahmoud Qureshi,
Minister of Foreign Affairs,
the Republic of the
Islamic Republic of Pakistan,
Votre Altesse
Prince Faisal bin Farhan bin Abdullah,
Minister of
Foreign Affairs of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, Chair of the 14th Islamic Summit, Excellencies, Representatives of the States
and
international organizations, distinguished audience,
Assalamu alaikum
wa barakatuh.
To the world,
at the outset, I would like to thank
all member states
for electing me as the Secretary of the Organization of Islamic Cooperation, and I avail myself of the opportunity to meet Your Excellencies, Your Highness, to assert that I am honored to serve our member states and the Muslim worldwide, Muslim community worldwide. I pray to Allah Almighty to help me undertake this responsibility, and I am sure that Your Excellencies will always support and guide my endeavors through Your counsel and support in this regard. I express in this regard heartfelt appreciation and gratitude to the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, the chair of the 14th session of the Islamic Summit, for calling for this so important meeting as part of the Kingdom's firm commitment to supporting Islamic solidarity and joint Islamic action. I also thank the government and people of the Islamic Republic of Pakistan for their most cordial welcome and generous hospitality to my daughter's person and to delegations participating in this meeting for the excellent arrangements to ensure that the aspired results may be achieved. By hosting this important event, Pakistan reaffirms its total commitment to the issues facing our wider Muslim community with a keen dedication to maintaining security and peace in the region. I would like also to express gratitude to you, all excellencies, for attending this meeting and for taking the hardship to join us despite the travel complications related to the coronavirus with its new variant Omicron. This effort best expresses Islam's universal message of harmony and harmonious relations and solidarity. Honorable Prime Minister, we view this meeting as a very important event in support of the Afghan people. All the more so because the issue of Afghanistan has been high on the OIC's agenda for decades. The organization has always taken strong positions supportive of this member country. The OIC General Secretariat has been following the unfolding events in Afghanistan with great interest, being fully committed to the region's peace, security, stability and development. Based on its charter principles of promoting peace and security, in which the principle of non-intervention in the member states' domestic affairs as well as strategic national choices, the chair secretariat calls for upholding sovereignty, unity and territorial integrity of Afghanistan. In this regard, the chair secretariat calls for all Afghan parties to work together in the best interest of the Afghan people. The call is also for all parties in Afghanistan to protect people's lives, refrain from violence, and work towards achieving the aspirations and stability of the Afghani people.
General Secretary has reaffirmed his full support for reconciliation in Afghanistan, expressing hope that all parties will commit themselves to peaceful dialogue to resolve all differences. It also stresses the need to respect international and humanitarian law and observance of Islamic and universal human rights. Moreover, the OIC General Secretary expressed full readiness to cooperate with the region and international efforts to bring peace for the Afghan people, mobilizing all its potential to contribute positively to peace, security and stability in Afghanistan and establish necessary contacts in this regard.
Honorable
Prime Minister, the role of the OIC member states of in delivering humanitarian assistance is more necessary than ever before because of the growing humanitarian challenges facing the Afghan people that the coronavirus pandemic has exacerbated. In this regard, we call for promoting the role of the OIC mission in Kabul with the necessary financial, human and logistical resources to fully deliver its full responsibility in supporting development in Afghanistan. We also call on the member states and all OIC institutions to deliver humanitarian assistance through the OIC mission in Kabul, in keeping with the recommendations of the final communique of the open and extraordinary meeting of the level of permanent representatives to discuss the situation in Afghanistan and at the OIC headquarters in Jeddah in 2021. In this regard, we commend the humanitarian assistance provided by some member states to the Afghan people, including the airlift launched by the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia simultaneously with the beginning of this conference. In this regard, we also call on all parties concerned in Afghanistan to cooperate fully with the OIC's mission in Kabul to create favorable conditions for civilian safety and security and enabling humanitarian institutions to provide relief to affected populations in Afghanistan. Honorable Prime Minister, Excellencies and Ministers of Foreign Affairs, the international community is called upon now more than ever to ensure Afghanistan is never again used as a platform or haven for terrorist organizations and that there is no foothold for terrorist groups in the country. For the international community to achieve this, it is called upon to find sustainable political solutions to the situation to help bring the country back into the international mainstream and benefit from the global economic and financial systems. Honorable Prime Minister, honorable Foreign Ministers, in conclusion, I would like to reaffirm the full support of the OIC's General Secretary for regional and international efforts to bring stability to Afghanistan. The OIC is ready to carry out a follow-up on the implementation of the outcome of this supporting meeting and to play its role in supporting humanitarian action in Afghanistan in coordination with the relevant OIC institutions and with relief agencies across the Muslim world, United Nations, I wish this meeting full success in its deliberations. Wassalamu alaikum wa barakatuh.